this video I will completely ruin it all. It's a few months later when I edit this video and I'm still upset. Hang on and you'll see. But first, off camera I've laid almost all decking onto the front of the terrace. I started by cutting down the joist to the correct length. I used a track saw to make it easier to get to the same length for all the joists. Then I cut each joist afterwards. Now I will mount the crossbeam on which the railing will be mounted. I then screw the crossbeam to the outer joists using brackets. I fit one screw, then I check that all is in level before I fit the rest of the screws. I noticed that the crossbeam was bent downwards. I should have mounted it the other way, but instead I got the biggest convincer, the car jack, and I convinced it to be straight. Then I used joist hangers to securely fasten the crossbeam to the end of the joists. Then it was time for the last decking board. The decking board was of course a little bent, so I had to use a strap and my little convincer to convince it. Mind you that the two outer joists are sticking out a little bit more than the middle ones. If you click the subscribe button, you won't miss the explanation. Then it was time to trim the edge of the decking. I used a chalk line to mark where to cut. To trim the edge of the terrace, I used my track saw. When I was cutting the joists, I discovered that I had cut into a screw or a nail with a fine-toothed blade. So before I cut the decking, I had changed back to the blade that came with the saw. Then I started cutting. You can probably hear the saw struggling. That's nothing new. The saw has never operated well. It was not exactly smooth as better. So I pushed through. You see what happened here? Well, I didn't. Not until there. At least the cut was exactly where it should be, so that's good. It still angers me. Well, obviously the cheap blade had lost a couple of teeth. I had to take a couple of days off doing something else and buying a new blade. So then I was to cut the rest of the decking. That didn't go smooth either. For some reason the blade pulled away from the track, but I found a workaround. With the experience from the previous disaster, I did not like this at all. I guess this is not the proper way to use a track saw. My advice to you, never buy cheap crap. If you like this advice, don't hesitate to subscribe. Thanks for watching and hope you will watch the next video when I'm tiling the first step of the stairs.